tonight. Sketchy details.
The sketch is no longer relevant. That's correct. Last incident, three shots were fired. In the second incident, one shot was fired and there was a stab wound to the neck.
Kennedy cleared.
The tape showed that the nurses were not telling the truth. They were not telling the truth about what led up to that final encounter.
Electric shock.
These apartments have light and heat. Some of them are on the grid. Others are being run by giant generators. It's a giant problem from top to bottom.
The news is now.
Hello, I'm Jody Applegate. Now your Pix 11 at 10. In custody, a person of interest in the killings of three Brooklyn shopkeepers. He's a man known as John Doe Duffelbag. Arthur Chen joins us live with the story. Arthur?
Jody, we now have the name of this individual, but Pix 11 has decided to withhold this name because he is not officially being named a suspect just yet. What we can tell you that the man they are questioning is in his 60s and is from Staten Island. As you pointed out, he is a person of interest in this very high-profile case, and this is being handled very carefully now, given the suspect in this case is potentially a serial killer.
We still want to speak to the male in the picture that we've put out.
It appears the police commissioner got his wish tonight when a man was taken into police custody, identified as the person of interest that we've been calling John Doe Duffelbag, the same man from this surveillance video circulated involving a string of murders of shop owners of Middle Eastern descent in Brooklyn. Apparently well-planned and in cold blood, whispers of a serial killer.
He was in the vicinity when, roughly at the time, we believe the murder took place.
The FBI's famed behavioral unit also brought in on a case with three victims in the last 5 months. The men have no personal connection before now. Their only similarity, the fact that the three men are older, Middle Eastern shop owners in South Brooklyn, alone at closing time in their establishments that do not have internal security video, killed by the same 22 caliber weapon at point blank range. Money not a motive. The last victim still had $171 left in his pocket. Shop owners are freaked out. Understandably.
It's very, very scary. I really don't know what I can personally do to protect myself from something like that.
No internal security camera has meant no exact time of death. Their bodies were discovered later, and so surrounding surveillance videos have been used to identify people who were close by at around that time. A painstaking but necessary process to get to interview them. Until tonight, everyone had been accounted for, with the sole exception of John Doe Duffelbag. Again, police are questioning a man in his 60s from Staten Island. We have his identity, but seeing as it's early in his questioning and he's not been named a suspect, we are not releasing his name. Our source tells us that police were following him for quite some time and arrested him in a pharmacy here in Brooklyn tonight. We'll have to see exactly what it means for this case. We'll keep you posted tonight and also tomorrow morning with the morning news beginning at 4:30. But for now, we're live in Brooklyn. Arthur Chan, Pix 11 News. We go to Narmeen Chaudhry in Lower Manhattan.
He's the Kennedy who got himself into quite a bit of trouble after getting into a scuffle with some nurses at a hospital maternity ward when he wanted to take his newborn child out for some fresh air. Well, today, some news to be thankful for. Kennedy was acquitted of all charges against him.
The tape showed that the nurses were not telling the truth.
Douglas Kennedy, the son of late Senator Robert Kennedy, cleared of charges of child endangerment and two counts of harassment. The charges stemming from an incident that took place nearly a year ago after the birth of his newborn son. Kennedy claims he was trying to take his baby out for some fresh air at Northern Westchester Hospital, but nurses confronted him and tried to stop him, telling him it was against hospital rules to do so. All of this resulted in a 7-minute scuffle, all caught on camera.
Thank God for the videotape. It was that very tape that turned out to be the key bit of evidence that ultimately supported Judge Donahue's decision.
Kennedy's attorney says one nurse claims Kennedy twisted her arm, but that action is not seen in the video. The court found instead that the claim was not supported by any evidence except in her own testimony. Our calls to the hospital were not returned, and the Westchester County District Attorney's Office had no further comment on the case. Gottlieb, meanwhile, says his client is thrilled to be able to put this behind them.
A nurse, contrary to all accepted procedures and practices, grabbed for a father's son. And that parent, that father, had an absolute right to then shove her away to protect his baby.
Kennedy's attorney says that there were rumblings of the two nurses involved in this case pursuing a civil suit at this point. However, he says because of the judge's decision, pursuing that would probably not be the best idea. In Lower Manhattan, Narmeen Chaudhary, PIX 11 News.
Narmeen, we learned a lot during the reporting of this following story, namely that homeowners devastated by Hurricane Sandy do not need to feel like they're alone in the painstaking process of dealing with their insurance companies.
It's been weeks since Hurricane Sandy tore through Dennis Taussig's Massapequa, Long Island home, and he's still reliving this nightmare as if it happened yesterday.
The water came up right through the floor because the basement, the crawl space, filled up, and it just, the water, surface water, just came right up through my floors.
The 4-foot-tall section of moldy sheetrock Dennis was forced to remove is still missing. The subfloor is still visible, and his waterlogged living room furniture is still outside, in the backyard. Keep in mind, getting to this point, ripping out all of the storm-damaged materials has not been cheap.
I put out probably over $20,000 out of my pocket to get to where I am right now and yet to receive any reassurance that I'm going to get a cent back, really.
I'm assuming this is money that you would have used for your retirement.
Exactly, which I was planning on in another year, which is probably going to be put off.
Dennis and his wife, Carol, who almost lost this house to the South Oyster Bay, say they are unsure if they can continue paying for all of these expenses out of pocket while their insurance companies drown them in a sea of red tape.
The red tape is enormous because the insurance companies are giving it out to outside adjusters to come and do a scope of work on the house, and there seems to be issues with that and getting the people in.
Carol took a leave of absence from her job to deal with this mess.
It looks like you've been busy.
Very busy with our insurance companies.
She now spends most of her day in a makeshift command center, which doubles as her living room bay window.
These are all the people I've talked to. I've talked to at least a dozen people, and each person comes up with a different story, a different day they're going to be here, and what's going on. Some tell us that we can throw away our furniture. Some say keep your furniture. I'm documenting everything because no one seems to know what they're doing.
Part of the problem is the Taussigs are not alone. Their neighbors here on this street and residents in communities across Long Island are all facing the same challenges. They're all relying on the same pool of contractors to begin tearing down their homes and all calling the same insurance companies who will hopefully pay for it all.
Gotta put the server back. This all has to come off today.
The Taussigs believe getting an acceptable claim settlement won't be easy.
Insurance companies are out there to make money.
Dennis is now trying to hire a public adjuster to help file his insurance claims. The goal? A thorough, more comprehensive claim packet will hopefully compel his insurance company to agree to a higher settlement. Florida-based public adjuster Rick Tutwiler says his job is to take away the burden of proving a claim away from a distressed homeowner.
After a claim has been created, the insurance company will go out and hire their own adjuster to represent their interest in the claim. And homeowners need to educate themselves and realize that there is an option for them to hire their own adjuster.
For Dennis and Carol Taussig, who have been asked by their insurance companies to essentially itemize their lives on a piece of paper, a helping hand is just what they need.
The biggest problem is you really don't know where you stand.
We spoke with Travelers, which is the Taussig's point of contact for their flood insurance. A company spokesperson tells us that they're aware of the growing frustration among storm-affected residents, but the company spokesperson tells us that the Travelers Insurance Company has established an around-the-clock, dedicated line for customers affected by the storm, and that so far they've been able to contact 97% of their customers and inspect 80% of their homes. Travelers could not provide us with those numbers for their flood insurance and homeowners insurance numbers total. We are going to continue to follow up with the Taussigs to see how their claim is doing. Live in the newsroom, Jay Dow, PIX 11 News. Jody.
Thank you, Jay. And now to the latest from the PIX 11 News Desk. Kevin Clash, the voice of Elmo, is leaving Sesame Street. He quit after another man accused him of having sex with him when the man was just 15 years old, so a boy. Last week, a man accused Clash of having sex with him when he was 16. He recanted after a monetary settlement, though he then seemed to regret recanting. We caught up with the new accuser.
I confessed to him that I wasn't, that I was still in high school and that I was 15. And he didn't seem surprised by it. He confessed to me that he wasn't 36, that he was in his 40s. It was really disturbing to me that he was 2 years older than my mom.
He always thought it was an isolated incident and that he's concerned that there's other teenagers who may have been involved sexually with Kevin Clash. And so part of it is to come forward. The best way to protect kids in the future is expose predators.
Clash has been on Sesame Street for 28 years. Sesame Street says Clash's personal life has become a distraction. The so-called soccer mom madam will not have to do any more jail time. Anna Christina got off with time served. Prosecutors claim she ran a high-end hooker ring on the Upper East Side. She served 6 months at Rikers Island when she couldn't make the initial $2 million bail. Christina will remain free on 5 years probation, but she could be deported back to her native Scotland. A horrible scene on a busy city street. A skateboarder was killed in Union Square. The 24-year-old fell. When he bent down to pick up his board from the middle of the street, he was run over by a delivery truck. Hamas says a truce has been reached between Israel and Gaza. Israel says it's close, but it's not a done deal. Today, masked gunmen publicly shot six suspected Israeli spies and dragged their bodies through the streets. We'll have a much closer look at the crisis in the Middle East later in the newscast. Four California men were arrested for terrorism. They're charged with plotting to kill Americans and destroy U.S. targets overseas by joining Al-Qaeda and the Taliban. Information on the plot was gathered after the men unknowingly told their plans to a spy working for the FBI. PETA thinks the annual turkey pardon is for the birds and wants President Obama to stop the Thanksgiving tradition. PETA says the ceremony, quote, makes light of the mass slaughter of 46 million gentle, intelligent birds. The animal rights group called the ceremony outdated and accused the president of being in partnership with the turkey killing industry. This is video of last year's pardon. The Thanksgiving pardon dates back to Abraham Lincoln. And that's tonight's top tweet topic, turkey. Why go through the elaborate ritual of pardoning one bird when we all know that a different, nameless, unloved, and unlucky turkey is slaughtered, plucked, quietly carried into the White House, cooked up, and served as part of a delicious family feast? Is it holiday hypocrisy? Culinary cruelty? Tweet me at Jody Applekay.
Lady, I've got to get home. She said her husband was coming up the stairs. Quiet. Hurry up and get in the closet. She said, don't you make a sound or some shit is going down.
R. Kelly is out with new installments of Trapped in the Closet. Chapter 23 is already online, and you can expect a Broadway musical to go along with them. Yes, R. Kelly plans to bring his hip hopera to the stage, and he says he may even appear in a few performances. That brings us to number 11. 11 is weather. Let's get over to Mr. G standing by at the weather wall. G.
I'm getting set for the holidays, and I hope you are as well. It's going to be okay for tonight. Real nice, I think, for tomorrow. So let's get to it. We're clearing out. The swing beam is dry. The radar is dry. There's a lot of sunshine heading our way across the Ohio Valley. The temps are on the cool side. Big spread north where we're cooling down at 29 Montgomery, 44 here in the city. The map is seasonable. Let's call it that. No major storms in sight. So here we go as we approach the big holiday. I like this graphic.
Oh, money?
Yeah, in heaven. So next 48 hours are good. And
this is what the holiday season is all about.
And Black Friday is coming, and the weekend's coming, and money in heaven is coming.
Cyber okay. Saturday and whatever and we're calling the Sunday of the
weekend. Lonely Sunday. No, the holiday weekend is coming.
When we're all inside cyber shopping anyway. Right. Thank you, Mr. G. Weather wraps up your Pix 11 at 10. We'll be right back. Next, power play.
That's the sound of progress as generators bring heat and electricity to people who have been without, but it's also shining a light on a problem here in Redwood.
Remembering Joey.
It's emotional. Like, we called him Uncle Joey for a reason.
He was
very big part of my life, I'm going to tell you, us.
The troubled twin.
Natalie and her twin sister, Jill Kelly, are very close.
Jill has loved and supported me through the years, and I plan to love and support her unconditionally.
I pull out my Beretta. He walks up to the closet. Get closer to the closet. Now he's at the closet. Now he's opening the closet.